there. Oh no. Ads are starting, guys. And for some reason I can't snooze it, so in about 2 minutes, we're going to ads. Before we head out to ads, what I use for the webbing in the center, believe it or not, is just waxed floss. Generic. Got it at the dollar store. So does anyone have any questions about the Dreamcatcher before Hi, Mama Rita. Sorry, we're just about... Is the stream gone? Oh, I did not see that, Killer Kitty. Yeah, Sir Beanie, get with me in Discord at some point, and we will chat. Are we back? Okay. I am doing my smoothie slowly. Are we in ads? It's not saying. It's just showing my bitrate is real crappy. Okay. We is back. Alright, so yeah, we just use waxed floss. It doesn't have to be high-end stuff. It can be, you know, dollar store stuff. And, ooh, keep bumping the camera. Take a length. Use the little thingy to cut it. And then, because this has bits of color, I'm going to tie it at the end of the darkest purple. You want to make sure the knot is real good because the webbing can get very tight. And you don't want the knot pulling out. So I'd do about three. And then give it a good test. Just making sure you're pulling it tight. Okay, good. We are back. Yay! Yep, it says connection is excellent now. So that's good. Okay. what we're gonna do is take a bead. Oh, which bead do we want to do first? We'll do this one because it's pretty cool. And you thread it on. Now, because the colors are pretty evenly spaced out, that gives me a good guide to where to put the string. So you lay the string over the top of the hoop, come up and go through the little hole that you created. Because you see how there's a little hole right there you created? Yep, you go through that. Put it at the end of that dark purple, and you pull tight. Then you go on to your next color. That's a neat big one. That one. We'll go with that one. So is everyone having a good day? Hopefully. Let me tell you, there's been enough bad days for a lot of us that we need a break. Okay. So again, you're going to lay it over the top of the hoop. Oh, Luna's zooming. Please excuse the crashing noises. And that will create a little hole there. You pull your string up through that hole. Move it where you want it. And pull tight. And you just kind of repeat that all the way until you get back to here. Oh, I didn't read the story yet. Okay. Give me a minute. Let me thread this through and I will read the story of the Dreamcatcher. Come on. She likes to crash into the wines because she likes the sound it makes. So you're probably hearing that. Oh no, not good, Mama Rita. I'm sorry. I hope you feel better soon. Yeah, COVID is not anything to mess with. Story of the Dreamcatcher. Many moons ago, during a very bad winter, a medicine man had a dilemma. His grandson had been suffering from nightmares for quite some time and was becoming weaker and weaker because of them. Fearing he would lose his grandson, he traveled to a high mountain to speak with the Great Spirit. His travels were fraught with storms so severe he wasn't sure he would even make it. After great struggle, he finally made it to the top. He created a bonfire and prepared himself to commune with the Great Spirit. The medicine man lit sacred herbs and said many prayers, and finally the Great Spirit answered him. "Go to the deep forests and seek out Grandmother Spider," said the Great Spirit. "Take with you your finest beads and the best hoops you have." So the medicine man returned to his village, gathered the materials, as well as some sacred tobacco to offer as a gift to Grandmother Spider, as it was custom to give gifts when you visit someone. He traveled deep into the woods, searching high and low without any luck. The weather had cleared, but the snow was deep. Finally, he found a clearing and a copse of birch trees. He sat and communed with the nature around him. And suddenly, he heard faint sounds of sweet singing. He followed the singing until he came upon many beautiful woven webs. In the center was Grandmother Spider. "How Natukka, Great Grandmother Spider," he called in greeting. "How Natukka," she greeted back. "Welcome, Medicine Man.
Please sit by the fire and warm yourself. The medicine man sat by the fire presented his gift to Grandmother Spider, who took it graciously. This is a grand gift, she said. Please tell me, why have you sought me out during these harsh times? The medicine man explained his dilemma and his quest to the Great Spirit and what he had said. Grandmother Spider listened intently, nodding as the man told his story. When he had finished, she pondered for a moment and then responded. You see, said Grandmother Spider, all of life is a cycle. You are born, grow, and eventually return to Mother Earth. Just like the leaves of the tree, they are born, grown, and when then the time comes, they fall off the trees and return to Mother Earth. Give me the items the Great Spirit asked you to bring, and I will teach you the ways of the dream catcher. He gave her the items, and she began to weave. As she added a bead, she said, within this cycle are good and bad spirits who are constantly at war. The bad ones like to prey on humans when they are asleep because they are more vulnerable. They send bad dreams to the sleeper to make them sick. The dream catcher catches these bad dreams and traps them in these beads. The good dreams are then allowed to filter through, down the webbing, and into the dreamer's head. In the morning, Grandfather Sun shines on the dream catcher, destroying the bad dreams. The medicine man listened as she spoke, weaving the intricate webbing. When she finished, she sung a little medicine prayer over the dream catcher. Sleep, little one, sleep tight. Never mind the bad dreams of the night, for I will keep the nightmares at bay and destroy them by the light of day. Grandmother Spirit handed the medicine man the finished tube. Now you know the medicine of the dream catcher. Go to your people and spread this wisdom. The medicine man gazed in awe at the dream catcher, tracing the web and marveling at its beauty. He thanked Grandmother Spider and made his leave. When he returned to his village, he told his people of his quest and placed the dream catcher over his grandson's bed. That night, his grandson had no nightmares and woke up the next morning excited to tell his grandfather about his slumber. Many of the village heard the miraculous medicine and came to the medicine man for help. He taught his people the story of the dream catcher so that they too could share this medicine with the others. And that is the story of the dream catcher. And there you guys go. Oh, thank you, Starry. I was probably 5 or 6 years old when my grandfather told me that story. And then he helped me make my first dream catcher, which I still have. It still hangs above my bed. So we're talking a dream catcher that's probably about 40 years old. So. Well, thank you, Killer Kitty. That's a really special story to me. Because like I said, my grandfather told me it. Let's see here. What do I want for my next bead? Let's go with this guy. And what I'm doing is just alternating the colors. That was a heavy glass bead. I did have some, I think they're purple. My hometown, I grew up in a town, and I live next to that town, where glass blowing is really prevalent. And a friend blew some glass beads for me. And I thought about adding them to this, but I kind of wanted to make a necklace out of them. Now see, this one's a crackle bead, and I'm not sure where the hole is here. It's somewhere. Is that it? No. What's the problem with crackle beads? Bright light on so I can see this. The hole is somewhere. That's horrible. I can't find the hole. Friend gave me this bead, and she's gonna find it hilarious. In my luck, it probably doesn't even have a hole. We choose another bead, don't we? That one's kind of big. Come on, not you too. I see yours. Okay. Again, you put it over the top. Rabbit comes up through the hole. And you pull it tight. Yes, folks, I could not find the hole. This bead is another, it's a porcelain bead, and my very good friend Betty gave it to me. It was part of a necklace that she had ever since she was a kid, and it broke, and she's like, here, you know, thought you might like this. I'm like, heck yeah. Alright, so to move on to the next step, the little hole here that you made with your first hoop, you're going to start to tie it off. You weave it through there, and just like you did through the hoop, but you're doing it through the thread. You go through the hoop, pull it all the way back tight to where you first started and tied. Then you go over the hoop again, and this just ties it to make it tight. If I can get things to work right. Oh, come on. And you just pull it tight. Then you go behind through the little section hoop that you made, go through, and then go through the other hoop, bring it forward. Uh-oh, what did I miss? What can I not prove?
Now to go on to the next section, you push your bead forward so that it's at this corner here. You go through the little hole made here, and just like you were going out the outside, you go through, and this time you're going to bring it about halfway, and then you hold on to that, or attempt to hold on to that. I think I'm going to, this is also porcelain, it's a cool little skeleton bead. Oh, then I can't find the hole. Yeah, can't find the hole. Angelic, thank you for the raid. Hello, everybody. Welcome in, welcome in. How was your stream? What were you doing? Can I get a shout out for Mama Jewel? Or, yeah, for Angelic, please. Hello, Mama Jewel. Hello. Oh, I missed. Let me stop. All right, let me go back. Hello, Mama Jewel, Angelic, Silver the Diamond Witch, Tina's C. Thank you, everybody. Ooh, Amanda on Maui, redeemed map. All right, let me get to a spot where I can tie this off, and we will do the map. Well, actually, I just started the one, so that's fine. We can adjust. How's everybody doing? Hope the stream was great. Hope you all are having wonderful days. Oh, okay. Amanda, whereabouts are you? Probably a stupid question, right? Let's see. Very, very, very tiny. You were diamond painting a full moon. Oh, awesome. Awesome. I can't wait to see that. I'll have to go back and check out the VOD. No, I do not. But it is teeny, 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 tiny right there. Gotcha. Trying to get this to not be as springy. Yeah. There we go. Okay. But we're yep, back over here. We are making a 300 follower celebration dream catcher right now. And yeah, we're having some issues with getting beads threaded. You know, I couldn't find the hole. Yep. Okay. So again, like with your previous one, you're going to go about halfway
go through that little hole that was created here. Go in between, so you're going through the other hole that you create. I might have to move my camera down so you guys can see. And then you got another one. Again, push your bead to the right. Grab your bead. Pull it tight. Hold with your finger there. Wrap it around and through. See if I can thread it. There's no real specific way to align beads or anything like that. This is just the way I've always kind of done it because it was the way I was trained. But there's different ways, even different webbing, style webbing that you can do. I've seen some crazy, insane dream catchers. You know, double hoops, triple hoops, one that looks like a triple moon. A friend actually got me one of those for Christmas. Yeah, Christmas one year. Uh-oh. Am I still derping, kitty? You don't even have to put it in the center, really. Purple. That kind of looks cute. Funky baby. Ah! Teardrop. I dropped it. Get in there. So now I just, you know, kind of do whatever. Oh, I do not have enough string. Put that over there. So I don't typically like adding string until I absolutely have to. Because the knot sometimes doesn't like to go through certain beads because they have such tiny, itty bitty little holes. We're talking about holes a whole lot tonight, aren't we? Yes, we need to get the sounds going. That will be something that, you know, is on the must do list. Don't be a pain. Oh, it did come off anyways. Pain in the butt. Yes, little one.
Did you just use the litter box? Okay. It is not letting me snooze ad breaks. So ad breaks are going to be at about 4 minutes. If you can, get up, stretch, do some self-care. You need something, get something to drink, get something to drink while I fight this. But it says it's going to start in about 4 minutes. So maybe we can get this knot going if my fingers let me. Okay. I waited a little too long to add on. So now I've got only a tiny little bit to work with. Yes, little one, meow. Okay, we got it tight. Then my scissors. Hydrate. I will hydrate. Yes, kitty, give me a moment while I fight with this little brat. Okay. Because we're almost to the end. Almost. Right, so not only am I hydrating, I'm eating. So hawk. Two birds with one stone. Okay, let's see what we got here. Go with that one. It's more brown than white, but it's a cool bead. Now you've come back to where you put that halfway. Halfway one right there. Okay. So you did like you did before. You go through the circle you, well, not circle, but hole that you made. Before. And you tie it off. Like we did before. You go in front, pull it back to this spot. Luna wants to eat the thread. Of course she does, right? You go through the middle part here. No. Making sure you're not catching up your beads in that thread. And then you pull it. Again, and then you go behind one. You bring it back up to tie off. All right, ads are about to begin. I am going to go use the potty really quick, so I will leave you guys hopefully with some music. And we will be back. Hello again, people. All right. Ooh, my knuckle cracked. Okay. Thank you, thank you. Welcome back, Ronan. Sorry, my knuckles are popping and cracking on me, so. All right. So the dream catcher doesn't get too cluttered. What I usually do at this point is just do one whole round without beads. That way we can get everything a lot more snug and tight. So, you do your little rabbit hole thing where, you know, the rabbit jumps in the hole, jumps out a different hole, and there you go. Did everyone do their stretchies and get something to eat or drink or use the potty? I was going to move the camera down. Let me see if I can do it without it being too much of a pain once I get back to this other side. So you guys can see a little bit better what I'm doing. Alright, and then we're back to the beginning again. So we go through the hole after. The hole above. And hopefully you guys will be able to see a little better once I adjust the camera. I just want to get this tied off so it stays tight. Because if you let go of it, everything wiggles away and becomes loose again. Yeah, it slides a little better and it locks in a little better than embroidery thread and stuff like that. So that's why I use the wax. The one that I made with my grandfather had sinew, which is basically dried tanned animal intestine. He went all authentic for the one I did. Alright, guys, bear with me. You might get a little wobble here. I apologize. I just want to be able to get you guys closer. Are we moving? That might be too close. Closer. Yep, slide in easy and tight. Okay. So, we will go in the rabbit hole, come out of the rabbit hole, and then pull it about halfway. Grab the next bead. What one do I want to use? That one's kind of cool looking. Go in the rabbit hole. Out another rabbit hole. clear one is grabbing my eye right now. Alright, so we've got that one and that one. Why not? Let's go with a little flower petal. Oh, come on. I know there's a hole. Oh, it's because it's on the side of the flower. Not the center. Ha! I found that one! Beads and I are 1-1. Let's go with this one. I love you guys. Y'all are truly amazing. Oh, no. You know, I love this community. You guys are so amazing. You know, you don't have to worry about two-faced backstabbing stuff. We all support one another. You know, we love one another. That's what I love about this community. So, thank you guys. You know, I couldn't have made it to, you know, the 300 followers if it wasn't for you guys, you know, and all the lovely support, the biddies, the subs, you know, the donations. You know, you guys are just phenomenal. Mrs. Mad Ronin said, and no effing drama, otherwise anyone like that gets booted sharpish. Yeah. Yep, we don't do drama here. No drama, llama. Not allowed. Alright, we'll do this pretty little iridescent heart one. Gotta make sure I put the thread through right because we want it hanging the right way. Mrs. Mad Ronin, we are adults who craft, have fun, and support others. We are not kids in a playground, and nor do we want to be. Exactly. You know, if you want drama, go somewhere else. I've had enough drama in my life. I don't need it. That's a cool shaped one. Once I tie it off this round, I'll show you guys a little more of a close-up. Dang it. Go through the hole. I'll show you guys all the different beads and everything so you can see some of the detail and stuff. Oh, come on. This is supposedly an HD web camera that I'm using, but for the amount that I paid for it, I'm not asking too much. I think it was like $25, $26 maybe. Something like that, maybe. Yeah, I've had enough drama in my life. I don't need any more, you know. I want to be able to craft and hang out with my friends and just enjoy one another. Uh-oh. I don't know if I'm going to be able to use that one. It's got a little crusty on the end.
which sometimes you can get with beads. I might have to get my bead reamer out.
Yeah. Yep, if I want to use that, I'm going to have to. Okay. What else can I use?
Oh, let's use a seashell. They're always pretty. There's the drilled hole. Okay. Then we'll tie her off and I'll show you guys. Trying to pay attention to chat because I know that being closer, I'm more apt to derp. So I'm trying to pay attention to chat, guys. If I've missed anything, you know, just let me know and, you know. Gosh, I might only be able to do another row. I pulled out way too many beads. It's okay, it's better to have too many than have to try and hunt through and find more. Okay. So, this is the top. We've got a cool little bead with a little cool pattern there. We've got our little scully. A little bit of an opalite one, the bone, another sparkly, the seashell, a European Pandora style bead, a little flower, interesting little Maya decoration type thing, a little glass bead, another Pandora style one that's kind of like those two. Our iridescent kind of little heart. Weird teardrop doohickey dude. Porcelain bead. Bone bead. Which was ethically sourced. Another little crystal. Our seashell. So that's what we've got so far. And I think we're going to add one more row of beads and then do the final tightening stitch. And this dream catcher will be almost done. We'll just have to add the bead and feathers on the bottom. Gosh. Oh. Okay, final purple bead. What do I want? Gosh, so many cool ones to choose from. Let's go with this guy, because he's got some cool gold and blue metallic on the purple. Hello, Fake Stereo. Welcome on in. Thank you, guys. Welcome back, Angelic. How did you find us, Fake Stereo? And how are you doing? We are just finishing up the 300 follower dream catcher today.
small because we're going to be pulling it really, really tight for the final stitching. So you kind of want to go with smaller beads. Oh, you rated in. Okay. Well, welcome on in. Just get the bead in the hole, or yeah, the thread in the hole, and it drops. Such is life when your hands aren't always that great. You tend to drop things a lot. Now, next stream, I'm going to be making some charms and a bracelet for a couple ladies that are really important in my life. My great-grandmother had this beautiful family heirloom necklace, and she gave it to me, and unfortunately it kind of broke. So I am making some charms and a bracelet for these ladies. And I wanted to include one of those beads in the dream catcher. So there is the pearl from my great-grandmother's necklace. And then once I do with the charms and everything else, I'm going to go ahead and restring that necklace. And make sure it's nice and good so it doesn't fall apart on us again. Let's see here, another small tiny bead. We'll go with that one. Aww, yep. The onions be strong, folks. The onions be strong. So, and I already have a spot I really want to hang this that, you know, it's going to be up on the wall somewhere I can see. So that way I'm reminded how amazing all of you people are, let me tell you. I'm just blown away by the kindness and the love and the caring and the support. Oh, blubbering sound is called for. Well, if someone finds it or wants to make one, you know. We will add a sniffly, cryy type one. Alright, and the last white. What one do I want? Let's go with that one. Another porcelain bead. Okay. Sorry guys, I'm trying to get that bead where I need it to be. Okay, Solar Hawk, thank you so much for joining me. I'm sorry you're out of spoons. I hope you can get some rest and get them back. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you so much for the music. I will definitely be checking it out. It is on my to-do list. I will even underline it. Okay. Before I go around again, I'm going to add a little bit of so I'm not fighting it again. Oh gosh, that white is in my eyeballs. Oh, give Luna treats. I missed it. Sorry. And the hydrate. And see here, Luna. Will you take them off the desk? I hear you mew. Will you take them off the desk? They're right there. She's like, but Mom, they're not in my dish. This is highly unusual. Oh, you're going to put it on the floor and lose it. All right, let me put them in your dish. I tried, Ronan. Say thank you, Auntie Ronan. Say thank you, Auntie Ronan. Yes, there's more coming. Don't give me that dirty look. We should be done before my delivery comes. Okay. Come on, pick it up, hands. Yeah, we're getting close to the end here, guys. My hands are starting to not be happy with me. So, we did what? Two petals, three petals maybe? And the dream catcher. Not bad. And lots of Luna loving. Because she's a crazy little kitty. Pull that tight. And then I'm going to do a surgeon's knot on top of this. So a surgeon's knot is basically you take your thread, you go through your little rabbit hole twice on one side. And then on the other side, you wrap it around. Come on, fingers. Once, in the opposite direction, and then pull it tight. And that is a surgeon's knot. Yeah, I think we got quite a bit done today. Luna got her lovin's and snuggles. I, you know, remembered to eat. I'm sure you all know I am notorious for forgetting to eat. Oh, my garbage can isn't over there anymore. Look out, little baby. Alright, so just like before, we're gonna go through, tighten things up with no beads, and pull things as tight as we can. Now when you do that, you're going to want to grip that little spot where the thread goat went through and came back up, which can be a pain because you got to kind of, my fingers aren't long enough. I have long fingers. So you grab her there. Trying to make sure I'm doing this correctly, baby. Maybe. Oh, goodness, I'm going to have to just pull it all tight in the end because those holes became too small. That's okay. We can work around this. Where there's a will, there's a way, right, people? Yeah, everybody always told me I had piano fingers, whatever that meant. And now I'm like, okay, yeah, okay. Luna. She wants to help. She ripped that right out of my hand. She's like, nope, it's mine. It's a string. Hey, hey, no. Bad fur baby. And then you guys will see whose will are we trying to get a hold of, and do they have enough money to take? Oh goodness. Well, I think I'm going to plead the fifth on that one, or no comment. Stop tapping me with your nails. I know you're there. I know you want more treats. But I've already given you way more than what you were supposed to have. Let me tell you, being a pet parent, depending on, you know, how your pet's personality is, sometimes it's exactly like having a kid. We are back to the beginning. So we go through the front door. Maybe pull it tight. Okay. See how that cinches down? And then you go through. Damn it. The top door. Trying to keep it tight. Okay, I'm gonna have to. Come on, bead. Cooperate. Well then, it came undone anyways. Okay. Sure you do this to me. Well, let me finish tying. Luna, will you stop? I know you like the mouse. I know you like the toys. I know you like everything I own. But you can't have everything. Ronan. So, see how that really tightened up? Well, it's still kind of got a little bit of too much of a bouncy for my like, but I'm not going through again. My fingers do not want to. So, it is fine. We are fine. Everything's fine. Oh, great. Where did the string go? We are not fine. There we go. Found it. So the surgeon's knot apparently did not work because... Stop, little one. It came apart. Hi, Squudge. How are you? We're just finishing up the dream catcher. Once I get this other tail added, I will... Oh, goodness, I hate this. Hardest thing is trying to add string when you don't have enough string that you were working with
And your fingers don't want to work. Ha ha! Yay!
How was dinner? Can we get a shout out for Squedge, please? Lovely, lovely streamer, goddess of crafts. Yes, little one, I hear you. Are you telling stories again? Okay, there we go. We got that added. Now, I did not pick out feathers to hold out because a little miss likes to be a naughty little girl. So what we'll do is we'll add the beads for the tail. Like, literally, once I put the beads in, I have to either hide the dream catcher or hang it up somewhere she cannot reach. That is how naughty our little one is. Yes, you. So we add our beads on that, you know, have the larger holes. Yes, Squedge, we've been talking about holes all night. Big holes, little holes, holes you can't get thread through, holes you can't find. Yep, Luna's been absolutely spoiled rotten. Lots of scritches and loves and... Alright. You're going to want to add a bead that is like a stopper bead. And this just makes sure everything doesn't slide off. I still glue it anyways. You know, I put some Elmer's glue in these beads to lock everything in. But... Yeah. There's that, and now I've got to reach the bag that has the feathers in it, because we cannot trust little Miss Luna. Hi, Arnia, welcome in! I believe I have some purple and white feathers to match our color scheme. Find some purple feathers in these cool spotted ones. Ooh, hopefully I still have some right there. Haha. Floofy purple feather. Stacy Poople. Purple. Floofy purple feather. Okay, Squedge, thank you so much for stopping in. I appreciate you. You amazing, amazing soul. I appreciate everybody that has stopped in tonight to continue celebrating with me. Again, you know, I never thought I'd ever have 100 followers, let alone 300. So, you know, thank you guys for
know, just being here and being so supportive and getting me back into streaming. There's a white feather. We might go with two white feathers if we can. Or maybe another purple if the white one isn't available. Oh, look. We got a little mini white one too. Okay. There we go. Thank you, Squatch. Enjoy your time away in Spain. Floofy feathers. I don't have the quota ad, unfortunately, Killer Kitty. That is something that we're going to have to eventually do. But, yep. Maybe with the bag. Z-bab, z-bab. There. Okay. So. We start stuffing feathers into the hole. There's a hole. And you just kind of fiddle around with them until you kind of find something you like. Make me beat you. Yeah, we will. I promise we will. We will have a whole bunch of fun stuff. Yeah. Alright, and that final bead comes down. We stick them in the hole. And we arrange bead. Ah, right. Pearl bead, where we want her. And then there's our little feather tail. Welcome back, Ronan. A little better look. So yeah, to Luna, that's a cat toy. So, and then there's the finished dream catcher. I'll take a picture of it once I put it up on my wall and everything, so you guys can see it. But yeah, look at all the beads I expected to use. So that's all right. I can put them back in their containers and. There will be other topics. Good night, Starry. So wonderful to have you here. I'm so happy you got to join on in. All right, so I'm going to go to the stream ending screen, and I'll glue that in and hang it up when we finish here. But there's the dream catcher, guys. So let me go to my outro. Stream ending. Again, thank you everybody so much for just kind of coming in
hanging out. You know, spending time with me, you know, the follows, the subs, the bits, and you know, everything. You guys are amazing. Such a wonderful community to be a part of, and so welcoming. And you know, just really means a lot. And next stream might be tomorrow morning, depending on how I feel. I do have a 4 o'clock doctor's appointment. So it won't be the same time as it was tonight, but if I do one, it'll be tomorrow morning. Keep a lookout on the Discord. Is there anyone you guys see you want to raid? I haven't looked yet. Bad Ams. I have not looked to see who is on. Oh, Meditative Crafter is on. Okay. Well, then, let's... let's read them. Oh, Meditative. Huh. It's raid one, Mrs. Ronan. I can spell, I promise. There we go, and there's the raid call. And there's the thing for the for the Discord. So yeah, just keep a peep on Discord, and I'll let you guys all know, essentially, when I'll be going live. I do have set days that are Sunday and Wednesday. Those are usually in the morning, 11 a.m. Eastern. Monday night or Monday morning, I might throw in story time with Ams. So depending on, you know, how I feel and stuff like that, we'll see. But yeah, definitely look for me tomorrow. And if not tomorrow, I'll be there Saturday. Alright, everybody, thank you so much for stopping by. Bye.